Whenever you go to IKEA, have you ever thought where and how does this huge amount of furniture came from? Hi, my name is Sahil Sinha and I am a student at QUT studying International Logistics Management AMN 430. Today we are going to talk about how IKEA manages its supply chain and deals with its huge amount of suppliers. Let us see on how big IKEA is. IKEA was founded in 1943. And in these span of years, IKEA built around 430 IKEA stores in 52 different countries. IKEA has 44.6 billion US dollar sales in the fiscal year 2018. It is having 30 different distribution centers, 41 trading service offices in 30 different countries. IKEA has a huge amount of suppliers, which accounts to 1,400 present in 55 different countries. Purchases from most of its suppliers are from Europe. IKEA holds 12,000 different products on its website as well as on its stores. Prior to 2003, IKEA used to follow a pretty vague method of dealing with its supply chain. They were more focused on giving power to local stores to conduct the demand forecasting. This led to frequent changes in the planning procedure of IKEA as a whole. There was no standardized software which used to deal with the data that used to be accumulated from the sales of the previous years. This led to a huge disturbances in the supply chain of the company as a whole. This decided IKEA to change this supply chain method, and this was the planning which enabled IKEA to use three different enablers. The first one was planning organization, the second was data quality, and the third was software support. This is the new concept that IKEA brought about, and they decided to centralize the supply chain and developed a function known as IKEA of Sweden. IKEA of Sweden aimed at focusing on logistics, purchasing and planning. There were four steps that IKEA of Sweden used to follow: demand forecasting from the data of the sales of last year. This led to a material planning of the products, which led to the load planning, and thus at the last but not least, distribution planning was made to reach the product to the stores. This is the flowchart of how IKEA is currently using its concept of supply chain and its planning process. IKEA uses the data of market intelligence and plans its sales as well as demand forecast. Then they plan to the material planning, and which deals with the supply capacity planning of its supplier. The finalized product dealt with the transport planning, warehouse planning, and at last the store planning. IKEA also wanted and aimed at focusing on supplier relationship management. Thus, IKEA assisted a huge amount of suppliers in buying raw material using a software known as ICOM. They also used to train their suppliers with modern production technologies, which increased their production a lot. This also helped IKEA in getting orders frequently from the same amount of suppliers. IKEA was also focused on maintaining good relationship and a long-term relationship with their with a short amount of suppliers instead of dealing with a huge amount of suppliers. IKEA's current planning based on transport and using cost-effective methods for transport is that they are building distribution centers closer to the seaports so that they can use more of ocean transport rather than using road transport. They are currently delivering products directly from the supplier to the stores. They have a warehouse usually present at the bottom of the stores, in which there is a self-accumulating of products by the customers. This is the current logistics strategy that is being followed by IKEA. IKEA decided to follow a flat pack strategy, in which their products are generally flat packed in the cardboard paper. This allowed IKEA to use an efficient space where the stock was kept in the warehouse, in which they used to keep same amount of products in a large amount. IKEA used this in order to save time, and this led to direct impact in the reduction of the overall landed cost. So, what was the difference between old planning and new planning? Old planning led to a lot of disturbances in the manual work There was lack of trust between each members, whereas on the other side, new planning led to a coordinated and balanced supply chain in the company. And this is how IKEA is on the verge of becoming the largest furniture retailer in the world. Thank you.